YNN. Health Works.
Infertility is on the rise, and couples wanting to become parents are looking for help. One thing many couples don't expect is a problem with the man, but it's more common than you think. And Austin experts are helping to make couples more aware.
For about 6 months, I put that on the back burner. I was a little bit in denial and said I wasn't gonna go get it checked.
William Pittman and his wife have been married for 6 years. After trying for a baby for 2 years, they decided to meet with a doctor.
You know what? I'm ashamed to say that, but I thought it was my wife's.
But the doctor told William he should get a sperm analysis.
And when I did, it came out zero.
Pittman had been taking a testosterone medication for fatigue. He didn't realize the drug could stop production of sperm.
When I found out that it was me, it knocked me on the ground for a couple days.
It's a common misconception that men aren't a part of the fertility problem, but doctors say most of the time they are.
So at least 50 to 60% of the time, the man is involved, or there is an issue with male factor infertility.
And it's on the rise.
Rate of male factor infertility is increasing. We think that's probably due to exposures, whether it's something in our environment or a chemical that's exposing something that we have around us regularly. There's a lot of research and studies going into that.
St. David's South Austin Medical Center is offering a free seminar tonight at 6 o'clock to discuss male factor infertility at the St. David's South Austin Medical Center. For more information, visit YNN.com.